and you promised. You promised somebody, anyone, save a black girl's soul. Bring her out to know herself, to know you. But sing her rhythm, caring, struggle, hard times. Sing her song of life. She's been dead so long, close in silence so long, she doesn't even know the sound of her own voice. Her infinite beauty. She's half so scattered, without rhythm, no tune. Sing her sighs. Sing the song of her possibilities. Sing a righteous gospel, and let her be born. Let her be born in hands of warmth. I'm outside Chicago.
I'm outside Detroit.
I'm outside Houston.
I'm outside Baltimore.
I'm outside San Francisco.
I'm outside Manhattan.
I'm outside St. Louis.
And this is for colored girls who have considered suicide, but has moved to the end of their own rainbow.
Mom's little baby life short and mom's little baby life short and red. Mom's little baby life short and mom's little baby life short and red.
Dinner, and you're breaking all the houses. By invitation, a friend.
and she didn't let on. She knew from behind her waist was aching to be held. The pastel ivy drawn on her shoulder to be brushed with lips and fingers smelling of honey and Jack Daniels. She was hot, a deliberate coquette who never did without what she wanted. And she wanted to be unforgettable. She wanted to be a memory, a wound to every man arrogant enough to want her. She was the wrath of women in windows, fingering shades, old lace curtains, camouflage and despair and stretch marks. So she glittered honestly, delighted she was desired, and allowed those especially scheming, tactful suitors to experience her body and spirit, tearing so easily blended with theirs. And they were happy and lay on her lined sheets, full and wet from her tongue. So she kissed them reverently, even ankles, and just repeated.
She sighed in front of the sculpted man as it made herself a bath of dark, musk-oiled gypsum crystals and washed away through to wash the good walks in her mind's roses. Let me watch the king herself. Ordinary, brown, braided woman with big legs and full lips. Regular. Seriously intent to finish her night's work, she quickly walked to her guest, got up on her pillow, and began.
You'll have to go now. I have a lot of work to do, and I can't with the man around. Here are your pants. There's coffee on the stove. It's been very nice, but I can't see you anymore. You got what you came for, didn't you?
And she smiled. He would mumble curses or sit down by the washer and pee. I couldn't possibly wake up with a strange man in my bed. Why don't you go home? She could have been slapped upside the head or verbally challenged, but she never was. And the ones who fell prey to the dazzle of hips painted with orange blossoms and had no distance of wrist had wanted no more than to lay between her dazzling thighs and had planned leaving for a bump. She was so divine, devastatingly bizarre in the way her mouth looked round. And now she stood a regular, full of the same malice, livid indifference as a sister, warm from supporting a wooden uniform, or waiting by the way. And they knew, and they loved in a hurry. She gathered her tinkling with jewels from the bathtub, and she left a gable for a venue. She stored her rolls, silk roses by the bed, and when she finished writing the account of her diary and embroidered the moonstones and lilies, she placed the roll behind her ear and cried her song.
Music.
But somebody almost walked off with all of my stuff. Like a kleptomaniac working and stealing while forgetting. This is mine. This ain't your stuff. Don't want you put me back and let me hang out in my own self. Somebody almost walked off with all of my stuff and didn't care enough to send a note home to them for my own solo conversation. Or two sizes too small for my own tacky skirts. Hey, man, did you get a dime for my things? What can anybody do with something of no value on an open market? Hey, man, where are you going with all of my things? I need my stuff. This is a woman's trip. But won't you put me back?
Get this. Last week, my old man came in saying, I don't know how she got your number, baby. I'm sorry.
No, this one is it. Oh, hey, you know I was high. I'm sorry.
I'm only human, and inadequacy is what makes us human. And if we was perfect, we wouldn't have nothing to strive for. So you might as well go on and forgive me, pretty baby, because I'm sorry.
Shut up, girl. I told you I'm sorry.
No, this one is it. I do like I do.